Hey guys. Well, I felt like doing an instructional video today, and I thought I might do funk groove. I'm playing funk harmonica. I know there have been many videos on this topic. I remember Jason Ritchie, he made a video on this, and which is really cool, and I learned a lot of stuff from that video. And today, I'd like to also share my ways, my tricks, how I approach funk grooves, in mostly in melodic terms, because also rhythm and phrasing are very, I think, the most important in this case. But well, this is what I'll do. I have the backing track. It's called Funk Groove Backing Track. It's in G. So I'll be using C harmonica. I found the track on YouTube. The channel is Jam Tracks Channel, if you'd like to use that too. And so let's see. Let's lay down the groove. So what I noticed is that the sax players like to do long notes and then develop them into a phrase. They like, for example, fifth, which in G minor will be D, and that's they also like to do high notes, and the highest D is 8th bar. It's difficult to play the 8th row very powerfully because it's a very short read. So we can go to the middle octave, where we also can bend into the note. And do a nice phrase like this. Repeat it with different phrasing a bit. Yeah. You can also stick to the blues scale, but it might sound a little repetitive after a while. Something like that, whatever you like. You can go up, down, harmonica, do the overblows, or whatever. There's an interesting note though, which in major would be a void note, and in minor is rather interesting. It is the fourth. In the case of G minor, it's C, which we get on the fourth blow. So it's nice to finish on that note. Play C in high octave, or the highest C, and then bend down to the B flat, which is the third of G minor. Or something like that, which is very effective. And we can do or imitate the brass section, playing the octave 1 and 4. So imitate the saxes and trumpets and so on. There's an interesting interval though I like to do, and that's C and E, the one hole and five hole. When you blow, you have C E. When you draw, you have D F. It's quite interesting. The color, the flavor is a little bit different, isn't it? So I like to do that when I try to do like a brass section, the replies to the singer, for example, and so on. Okay, you can also, the track is ending, I'll need to restart that then. You can also go to D minor blues scale, which will will play as if in a third position. You're still in G, but you're playing in third position, and you introduce a new note, which is A. So the point of reference will be slightly different. You will be ending on different notes, that is D, F and A, which is D minor, a chord D minor, and it gives a different flavor to it too. And the last thing I would like to do is a lick I came across recently, which lays nicely on the harp, and it involves bending. The phrase starts in the D minor, as if 6 to 7, 6 draw to 7 blow from bend, and then I go to G minor, try to repeat the phrase a tone lower. So let's see. Right, let's put it together, show you the promised lick in the actual context of the solo. Like that. So maybe I'll explain some more advanced playing outside another video, which will be coming soon, I hope.